I wanted to talk about the Mindy's muffins thing, because dude, we've been getting hit up left and right about Mindy's muffins now. Unbeknownst to people, I have never eaten at Mindy's muffins. I have never been a Mindy's muffins guy. But they said, you know what, Miss, you need to check out the reviews online of Mindy's muffins. You guys might find this entertaining. And I said, oh, okay, I'll take a look. So I went to Yelp, and I'm on Yelp. And the first thing it says is that there is a pop-up from Yelp immediately saying, this has unusual activity alert. This business recently received increased public attention, which means that people have only come to this page to post their views on politics and the news. While we don't take a stand one way or the other, when it comes to incidents, we've temporarily disabled the posting of content to this page as we work to investigate whether the content you see here reflects actual consumer experiences.
Okay, so you want to know why that came to pass? Why Yelp actually ended up doing that? Because years ago, and I had a friend, well, he's still a friend of mine, that owns a business, owns a restaurant, and somebody at his restaurant during the Trump shit was at one of the Antifa things or something. Like, it was one of those bullshit, you know, Antifa fucking Proud Boy things back in the day. And so one of the employees went there, and they were there to support the Antifa people, but they thought that they were one of the Proud Boy people. So they flooded the fucking business's page saying this restaurant employs fucking Nazis. And
yikes.
Yeah. I'm sure that happened a good deal on these pages in like 2016.
Wow.
So they now have to be a little bit present, and they have to be a little bit aware of that. Because
what you're saying is that these bakeries need to worry about white flour.
Right. They got to look. Yeah. They got to look out for these middle-aged white guys making problems on their page. That's what it is.
White flour. They got to watch out for white flour.
Yeah,
white flour.
White flour is supremacist. That's what it is. Oh, my God. Yeah, no, that doesn't surprise me. That doesn't surprise me that they did that. If anything, though, it's silly muffin reviews, but that's kind of the exact reason why they did that. Well, so people can't just go on a page and decide to shit all over, you know, somebody's business.
Well, they're not. It's actually getting bombarded by 5-star reviews for the most part. Like Jose O out of San Francisco, California says, best in the world. The muffins are great, but let me tell you about Scott Colton.
You know, that is basically what happened in the interview. Yes. To be fair, that was basically the scrum.
I love Mindy's Bakery. The other day I was eating a muffin in front of my boss, and then I felt such a high. I started to tell them about my friend Scott Colton. I think he wasn't very receptive, though. I went down the hallway at work and wanted to share my muffins with the EVPs, but they wanted the muffins for themselves. And we kind of got into a scuffle over the muffins, and my best friend Ace had to bite one of them in order to get them off me. All I know is when I looked down, I saw my dog Larry eating the rest of the muffins, because Larry knows how good these things are. Highly recommended. 5 stars from Todd P. in St. Charles, Missouri.
Oh, my God. God, do you know what, though? It's one of those things where you look at it and you're like, okay, so they bombarded Yelp. They made a problem for Yelp, fill in the blank, right? But like Lee just said, even in the chat room, he's like, we're going there when I'm coming. It's like, this will become a spot for wrestling fans now.
Yeah.
It'll become a place that people that love wrestling will go for the Instagram picture, whatever the fuck it's going to be. And that's not necessarily a bad thing for your business. You know, like nobody at this point is going, Mindy's muffins, that's the reason why Punk's a fucking narcissist. That's what it is. That must have started it. That chocolate chip muffin must be the reason why Punk has never gotten fucking appropriate therapy. Like,
Over under. That's gotta be it. Lifetime supply of muffins for free?
For Phil?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sure he's getting them.
Lifetime. Sure. Lifetime supply of muff for free.
They probably need to give him a fucking Zoloft muffin at this point. Holy fuck, dude.
Here's your Xanax muffin with chocolate chips there, Phil.
They're going to have to start dosing fucking Punk with mushrooms to try. With this muffin tastes like mushrooms. Yeah, well, yeah, it's a healthy one, Phil. Mm. It'll make you. Now, Phil, after you're done eating it, I want you to think about your parents. Think of this. Think of your parents and write the word forgive on a piece of paper. Oh. Just keep looking at it and looking at and touch it. Touch it. If you cry, that's okay. That's natural when you eat one of these muffins.
Saw a recommendation from an acquaintance of mine named Phil who lives in Chicago. Based upon what I've heard, this bakery sounds like they make the best muffins that make you want to rant about your ex-best friend who shares a bank account with his mother, complain about having to work with fucking children and empty-headed dumb fucks, belittle your boss and then super kick down a door, start a brawl, rescue a dog from said brawl, bite another person, throw a chair at someone's eye, and most importantly, be angry when finding out the journalist you're shouting at no longer does improv with your ex-best friend. All in all, sounds like an amazing experience, and I gotta try it if I ever find myself in Chicago again, beyond O'Hare Airport. Oh, by Nick C. in Belmont, California.
Oh, boy. Yes. Well, this is just, this is what this business will be known for now. But like I said, if it results in them being able to make a lot of fucking money from it, good.
Yeah.
Good. I hope they find a way. If I was them, I haven't visited their website, but if I was them, I'd be shipping over the country with different, I would have a CM Punk specific muffin. I would have one already made. Let me try to think. A Young Bucks muffin. What would that be? A Too Sweet muffin.
Well, you know what? Ramon O. from Lake Forest, Illinois says, you've got to try this place out, Joe. Great food. My friend Ace enjoyed the French toast so much that he bit me. True story. But the best menu item is hands down the mac and cheese ratatouille. It's so damn good. It brought my two friends, Phil and Scott, back together. They hadn't talked in 8 years because of a staph infection. Hope you give it a try. Tell them that you're an EVP for a special treat. Enjoy.
I like that. They haven't talked for 8 years because of a staph infection. I like that being the only reason.
Yeah.
Oh, but by the way, not to derail the walls here, but I thought it was funny because this just kind of struck me the other day where when CM Punk was talking and he goes, you know, I offered him money and he didn't take it. I'm like, well, you did try to sue his mom.
Yeah.
Let's gloss over the fact that you did try to sue his mom.
Yeah, so that is a giant fuck you. Suing somebody's mother.
Yeah, because you're mad at them. Yeah. You know, Phil, they people usually don't like that. They don't. They're not the biggest thing. Like when you fuck with I know he probably or seemingly has no relationship with his family, but most people don't like that.
Right.
When they're like, oh, hey, I'm mad at you, so I'm going to go to your house and fucking, you know, I don't know, break your fucking dad's lawnmower. Yeah, they're not happy. People don't like that. People don't like that. By the way, speaking of dads and lawnmowers, Keith Lee looks like a dad that just got done mowing the lawn on Wednesday night.
Oh, yeah.
Didn't he? Like, he looked like he just came in. He was kind of sweaty. He hadn't shaved. He took off his like white Air Force Ones and was like, oh, you goddamn kids. I'm going to catch a heart attack out there. Like that's what he looked like on that show. But,
yeah.
No. Yeah. Like this hopefully makes her a fucking shit ton of money.
Oh, you know, they are. Yeah. You know, they're making bank off this shit. I mean, like there's just a ton of positive reviews. Yeah, Michael M. What is this one? Chicago baked good lovers while you lay there, hopefully as uncomfortable as you possibly can be. I want you to listen to me. I want you to digest these muffins before I leave in 3 weeks with the rest of them. I have a lot of things I want to get off my chest.
By the way, like now, you know, all this talk about these reviews, I just want to see a picture. Can somebody post some pictures of the muffins? I want to see what the muffins actually look
Pickle
like.
Pickle Cypher says, look in my eyes. What do you see? Muffins from Mindy's Bakery. I know you're hungry, hungry for sweets. Pastry's so good you can fight the elites.
The internet remains undefeated.
Undefeated.
No, is there an Instagram? Now I want to look up the Instagram and see if there's like fucking pictures of the food.
Well, I'm going to go.
Because I want to give them the credit here. Because you got to think, right?
You just go to mindysbakery.com, Joe. It's right on the front page. They've redone their page. And because I was on here the same day that he was plugging Mindy's Bakery, but they've changed their front page. And now it just expressively shows their wonderful muffins right off the bat.
That's smart. So, that's smart. Oh, this looks pretty. Ooh.
Yeah.
All right. These look good, dude. Look at this fucking.
Oh, yeah. Nice. No, I know he's not plugging some fucking Dunkin' Donuts version of shit.
Come on.
Right.
No. Dude, look at the fucking. This is like an Asiago. Kreller kind of deal.
I like the hot chocolate muffin. That looks fucking delicious. Or that blueberry thing at the bottom. Fucking Jesus.
Yeah, I'm looking at. Oh, dude. All right, bagels. I love coffee cake. Fuck yeah, dude.
Yeah.
I love. You know what? I like coffee cake, but I'm not the biggest fan of cinnamon rolls. I know that seems crazy. Sometimes a good looking cinnamon roll will do it for me, but I'd rather have coffee cake.
Mm.
Coffee cake fucking rocks.
Yeah, even those bagels look real good too. Yeah, oh, they've even got the Italian bread too. Wow.
Do you know what would be great is if CM Punk fucking actually had stock in this place? Like after all this, like he was partial owner.
Smart.
It was, shit. You know, CM Punk's whole his big whole plan. Like he's like, all right, I'm gonna go back to wrestling.
Yeah.
All right. I'm gonna go back. I'm gonna get in there. I'm gonna wrestle for about a year. I'm gonna get hurt multiple times.
Right.
Like multiple times. I'm going to win the world championship. Okay. I'm going to goad these fucking dorks into being angry at me. Then I'm going to yell at them.
But don't
then
you think,
I'm going to plug the bakery that I own.
Don't you think that's something the level of sinister you would expect from a guy like Phil Brooks?
Yes. Yeah.
Like
that's
you're
it.
Joking. You're joking. But I could actually see. I could actually see this being real. Like he's a backer. Like he's not actually public front. He's a backer. He's an investor in the company.
Do you know how funny that would be if it was a 2-year long grift for him to fucking plug a bakery? Like that's all it was. It was just fucking years. If it's like 7 years I've been out of the industry and I'll return. And he's like, God damn it. I got some fucking sour cream tarts to sell. I'll find a way to get Mindy's laminated brioche off the fucking ground.
God damn, that would be great.
Oh, wait. Mindy. MCM.
Oh.
Ooh.
Mindy's chocolate muffins.
Mm. I'm looking for clues now. I'm going in there.
Conspiracy.
I'm like Ryback. This is going to be my Ryback conspiracy theory. This is me being Brun right now.
Yeah.
What if, you see all you fucking marks got fooled. You thought this shit was all about wrestling. What it really is CM Punk actually owns Mindy's Bakery. And all you fucking marks got fooled. Now you're all going there and getting scones and shit. You don't even realize.
Dude, you're joking.
Punk even richer.
But I want to do like a Filthy Frank video about the fucking conspiracy connection between CM Punk and Mindy's Bakery at this point. I'm not even kidding.
We should make a loose change.
Do like a content cop or something. Just see they were on TV and dude.
What if we make a loose change documentary style thing about CM Punk actually owning Mindy's Bakery?
That'd be hilarious. We could do it. We could totally fucking do it.
It would only be better if we could get Cole Cabana to start.
Oh.
Is Colt on Cameo? You think we could pull that off?
How much money do you think it would take to have Colt Cabana dress up like CM Punk and play that role?
Oh, my God. It's $300.
Just use low key. Hi, this is CM Punk. I am CM Punk.
Hello, it is me.
That would be good if we got every guy that hates CM Punk to do a fake loose change documentary about him actually owning Mindy's Bakery.
But that requires us to talk to Teddy Hart.
Yeah, that's true.